Welcome to Unlock Layouts. In today's video, we are going to discuss how to add dummy based on CAD and Virtuoso tool. Let's start the video. In this video, so now we are going to add dummies in the current mirror. So this is my current mirror structure. So before only I have done the routing and every DRC, everything is cleared right now. So till now I didn't add any dummy. All the devices present here is all the active devices, but now I need to add one more dummy. So dummy, how to add dummy? Is it dummy is any kind of special device, or else dummy is also a normal device? So now I am going to explain you how to effectively add dummy. So now what I am going to do, I am just click one devices and I make a copy, C for copy, and I kept just away from here. So this is also the same active device. I am not doing any changes, any modifications in my layout. Just I took a copy of one more active devices. This is also active device. See, this is also active devices. But now I am going to make this active device as a dummy. So how should I make this active device as a dummy? So this is very simple. Just what I have to do, we have to merge this dummy device to the last source terminal. See, now this is my dummy device. So this is my active device. Till this source point is active source, but after this active terminal I have added one dummy terminal. So I have added one dummy terminal. So how should I make this dummy, how should I make this active terminal as a dummy? So what I have to do, just I need to place one via, O for via. So we'll go for a M12 poly via. Just click OK. Then now this is a single device, single fingered devices. So now what I'm going to do, O for via, taking as a two column, apply. So now what I'm doing, I'm placing my via over here. So exactly here. So now I have connected the two gates. So further way how I should avoid this, further way how should I make this as a dummy? Make it as a path from here to here, complete our routing from exactly here to here. So now the gate terminal and as well as the source terminal is shorted. So one more terminal we have, that is drain terminal. So again I am making one more path. So now what I did, drain terminal, source terminal, all the terminals I have shorted. And further way also I can improve this circuit, sorry, this layout. Just what I have to do, simply I am extending this via area. So just I am extending this via area. So exactly here I kept at the via. So just zoom it. So we have still we need some adjustment. So exactly here I placed my via. What I am doing, just taking one more path, P as a path, from metal to VDD, from source to also VDD. So now in my schematic, source terminal, gate terminal, drain terminal, and also this source terminal, all the terminals are shorted together. See, if you taking a closer look, so this is a drain terminal, this is one more gate, this is a one more gate, because it's a two fingered devices. So this is a one gate and this is a one gate. So we have a two source terminals here. So source terminal, drain terminal, and then also one more source terminal I have shorted by making a via over here. So via, drain and source are shorted. So here I have extended this terminal, which means that guard ring, so we can call it as a tap cell also. So now I have extended. So now I have added one dummy over here, same structure. Now I am going to add one more dummy in left side also. So what I am going to do, just I am going to click and C for copy, and just I am taking the same routing and I am placing here. And one more thing I have to do, I am just clicking here, copy, and I am taking one more active device. So in this active device we have a source terminal, drain terminal, and also source terminal. Just now go to zoom in, click here, move exactly to this source terminal. and just merge the source terminal with the last device. That's all. So now still what we have to do, we have to give the connections. So now what we have to do, we have to place the via over here. Just copy and place the via over here, exactly the via, then nothing, just take a path to this, up to this till end. Again this drain terminal also we have to connect to this. So we didn't connect it properly. So this one drain terminal also connected. So gate terminal, drain terminal, source terminals is also connected. So just S for stretch, extended this boundary to till this area. So nothing, this is normal routed. So just delete this. So we have deleted this metal over here. This is what I am doing. Again I am clicking path. Source terminal is connected to VDD and drain terminal is also connected to VDD. See, source and drain terminal is also connected to VDD. So now this metal also I have deleted, make it as a fit. See, this gate is a active gate, this is active devices. So over the active device I have added two dummy devices. So this one is one dummy device and this one is one dummy device. All the three terminals are shorted together and I just connected to the power VDD, because see now end of this source is connected to VDD. So that's why I connected source and drain terminal to VDD. Suppose if the source and drain terminal is connected to any other terminal, suppose if the source is not connected to VDD, suppose if the source is sharing the data to some other terminal, means then what I have to do, I have to connect all three terminals and directly I should connect this to gate terminal. So according to the schematic only we have to take a decision whether we have to connect this dummy device to the VDD signal or else gate signal or else ground signal. But dummy is nothing, that is also a kind of device, normal device only. Just by making source terminal, drain terminal and as well as gate terminal shorted together, it can act as a dummy. So now everything is cleared right now. Now again I am running LVS to check whether any DRC errors are there still. So now I am going to run the DRC. Total number of checks executed 1620 and the total granted errors are 3. So we have 3 errors here. So we have to solve those 3 errors. See, now in RVE window, so it's showing PP and NB enclosure is some error and some M1 metal is having some error. So first we will solve this PP MP error. So just click it and highlighting. So I know what kind of error is this, because before only we have a PP and NB enclosures error. So now extending the PP NP enclosure. See, because here only I am getting highlighted area. So same both way I have to increase the PP NP enclosures here. See, if you want to understand the full layout, just visit my first video, just take a look of my first video, then you can easily understand the second video. This is the continuation of my first video. So again in caliper tool we have one more error, M1 width error. Click M1 width error, just click highlight and minimize and see. See, some misalignments are there with metal. So while doing layout, so we have some misalignments are there. So see, you can able to see some highlights are there. Just click escape and click it and move this metal exactly. So now everything is cleared. So only, so we have a two kinds of DRC errors are there. So now again I am running DRC, we will see any DRCs are there. So now the caliper RVE is showing there is no DRC error after adding dummy. So now I cleared all the DRC errors. So friends, this is how we will add dummy in the both corners. So this is the way to add dummy. Okay, so the reason to add dummy, there are so many lots of advantages are there why we have to add dummies and all. So just That's a separate topic. So now in a layout point of view, practically I'm just sharing how to add dummy in the current mirror. I hope I have given some valuable information to you in this video. Thank you for watching my video. If you like this video, please click like button and share this video to your friends. For more details about this video, please contact us to my email ID and follow us on my Facebook page and Twitter page, and kindly subscribe our channel and don't forget to click the bell button.